In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can get data templates using Rapidstart and Nav to be able to populate data into the Nav system without having to go into the software and through, the item card or ship to address card, customer card, vendor card, etc., having to go into that specific place in Nav and manually enter the data. Sometimes it's a lot easier just to populate that data into Excel and then be able to import and export those templates to be able to update the data. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to validate that we're going to be addressing the correct table in Nav. And one of the easiest ways that I find to do that would be to go into Nav, navigate to the page in which you want to add the data. So in this case, say for example, I want to update my customer ship to information. So I navigated to my customer table. And then what I want to do is I'm just going to open this up here and I'm going to navigate to my ship to addresses page. So I'm going to select New, and you'll notice that if I were to manually enter the information into Nav, this is the page that I would use. But of course, I want to use RapidStart, and I want to use the Excel templates that I've got the opportunity to use. So I'm going to say Help, About This Page, and you'll notice that it gives me a source table. So the source table is what I need, and that tells me that if I want to enter information into this page, which table is Nav looking at. I can jot down 222, and now I can go into RapidStart and I can actually start creating that template. So I'm going to close out of there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to search for RapidStart. So I want to use the configuration worksheet because I'm just dealing with one table in this scenario. So what I can do is I can search for the table ID 222. And as I can see here, this isn't something that was given in the original package. So if it's not something, because in some cases you'll notice customer, vendor, item, bank account, in some cases it's already there. In other cases, we'll select New. The line type, I want to enter information into a table, so I'm going to select Table. I know my table ID because I went to that page and I went to the Help About This page, and I'm going to type 222. You'll notice that the name here is ship to address, which is what I want to populate, so that's good. And you cannot export or import any data using Excel without a package code. So the next thing that I want to do is I want to go up to the navigate, or sorry, actions, and I'm going to assign a package. It doesn't really matter if I use, the Microsoft Dynamics, or if I use the validation, or if I create a new one. All this does is it writes to the Excel file, what package it should be importing and exporting into, and it just kind of does it for traceability. So I'm just going to, for the sake of this example, select the first one here. Then at this case, I could potentially just export that template to Excel and start entering in my data. However, what I like to always double check is that I've got the right fields, the fields that I'm interested in, and I have any filtering that I need turned on or off. I like to take a look at that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look here under actions, under fields. So what this does is in that table, these are all the different fields that I have available to select. So had I had just hit export to Excel, anything with include field would have shown. But say, for example, I look at this and I think I also want my contact. I also want to be able to put their phone number in. Maybe I also want to put their fax number in, location code, their email address. So what I'm doing is I'm just selecting all the fields that I want to include in my export. Because when I export this template to Excel, I want to make sure that I can populate as much data as possible. And I can also, if I wanted to, deselect fields if I didn't want them. So I have the ability here to either include or exclude fields. And then once I've got my fields and my filters, I'm going to export to template. I'm going to open that. So in this case, it exported the four customer ship to address information fields that I had already. And now what I could do is I could continue. To just keep adding the ship to information that I have. So maybe I want this to be Edmonton It's a Edmonton-2 because it's a second address in Edmonton. I'm just going to enter in the information into the template that I need and I would carry on. So within the template, we have a few housekeeping rules just so that Nav will know how to read the import from Excel once you're ready and you want to import it back. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to make sure in row 1, A, B, and C, we don't make any changes to the information that's there. This shows the package that it needs to import it back into. It shows the table name and it shows the table ID. So if that gets changed or altered in any way, the XML behind the Excel template could break. And when we go to import it back in, Nav will be confused on what table it needs to enter the data into. So to keep the consistency and make sure that the information gets to where it needs to go, we just know never to touch these three columns. We also want to make sure to respect the rules here in which the data needs to come back. So in this case, we've got a text field that's 50 characters. So we can enter in free form alphanumeric information into there, but we don't want to exceed 50 characters. Or else Nav will say, I don't have enough space, and it's going to ask you to truncate to limit that field. If you have an option field, that means that Nav has options that it gives you. You have to select one of those options. If you have a Boolean field, that means that you need to answer true or false. So what we can do is in the headers here, it will tell you what type of field it's looking for and any character limitations that it has. We always want to make sure that we respect using those little rules. We don't want to insert new columns or make changes to the columns that are here because, again, behind the scenes, customer number, it knows that the A column is the customer number. It knows that B is code. It knows that C is name. When we start changing the names and when we start inserting and deleting cells, we can confuse the template. So we always like to use the cleanest template as possible. If we're finding out that we need additional columns that aren't there, best thing to do would be to create a new export, copy and paste the information into the new export, and use the data template with the proper XML mappings in the back. We want to make sure in any of the code fields that you don't use any special characters. So you don't want to use an ampersand sign, percent sign, asterisk sign, anything like that. It will import into Nav, but then once you go to look up a customer as an example or a vendor or an item into the lookup tables, when you're selecting them for various documents like your sales order, your purchase order, it won't find anything in a code field where you've got a special character. So do not use, you know, customer number. If it's A and B, don't use A ampersand B. Try a different method, AB or A, and then an AND, B. However the case, do not use a special character. Some of the things that we also want to be aware of is when you use an Excel formula to get data in. So say, for example, you wanted to determine whether or not to charge taxes, whether they were a tax liable customer. You may say, well, if the, you know, country region code was CDN, make this true. Nav cannot read Excel formulas, so what you would want to do is you would highlight the field, copy it, and then you want to paste it back as a value so that if the result was true or false or whichever, it behind the scenes reads true or false. It doesn't read, you know, VLOOKUP to a different column. Those are some of the rules around populating the data template. You can export any of the tables in Nav. Once you do that, you can populate the information and then you can save that to a location. And then, as I said, you can keep populating over and over as much as you need. One of the things to also be cognizant of is that when you're adding, you want to make sure that you're adding to the table. So you'll notice that there is a dark column around here, that means that this information will be read when the import happens. If, for example, we skip a couple cells, we'll notice that the dark line still stayed here. So this information will not be read. So you always want to make sure that whatever information you're populating is being populated within the table so that it can be read when you do the import back to RapidStart. Once you have that done, I'll show you in another video how to use the validation tool to make sure the data that was entered will import well. If you have any other questions on how to get a data template or how to export to get specific fields or filtered information, contact Sabre at 519-585-7524.